Hi, today I'm going to show you something really awesome I got hold of. This here is a USB Ninja, a BLE4O remote control for remote controlling cables where you can have a keyboard inside of the cable. So this here, this is actually a cable with a remote control, and you can get the cable where it's for an iPhone, or for with the normal USB, or I don't think this is for Macintosh or an USB-C 3.1. And all of these three cables here, they contain a remote control. If you compare those cables, or let's take the one for the iPhone, for example, and compare it with a normal iPhone, an original iPhone cable, you can see the difference between those two cables. That it's, I don't know if you can see this, it's a bit thicker, this fake one, than the original one. And you can also see down here that it's a bit longer than the original one. You can see this, right? Otherwise, they look the same. Actually, I think when I feel this, that the quality of this USB Ninja cable here is much better than the original iPhone cable. So you go and you buy it on usbninja.com. I bought it in a startup they had, and I got these three cables and these two remotes. I followed the help section down here on their website, and so how I installed Arduino for programming it. And I got hold of some samples, and it's pretty easy. You just you have a payload A and you have a payload B, and then you type in whatever command you want to have this remote keyboard to type. And then you just press compile and to program a cable. I'll show you. Let's take this one here and plug it in. Well, actually, I'm not plugging it in yet, because to program it, first you have to compile the code, of course, and then you have to have this magnetic ring where you can actually see that they have written something on it here in the elf language. I think it says one ring to rule them all. So, yeah. And when you've compiled, see here, I'll put the ring here to activate read contact inside of it or something similar. And then when it's done down here, it'll say plug it in, ready to compile, ready to upload the code to the hardware. It's taking some time. The first time you compile, of course, it takes longer time than the next and the next, because you have some caching going on there. By the way, I bought the big package, so I got two of these remotes here. You see, you've got another one over there. And when you plug in the cable, the remote is actually telling you that the cable is online. So you can see here, when I switch it on, there's a little button here on the side. It starts blinking. You see that? And as soon as I plug in the cable, now I know it's for programming, but it doesn't matter, it stops blinking. It detects that the cable is online. So if you're going to do a red team exercise and you're walking around in a company where you're trying to figure out where the guys who got the malicious cable they are, you can just watch this one here. And when it stops blinking, you know that you're near the target. These here works up to 100 meters. If you combine it with an antenna like this, it's also in the package. It's a 14 dB gain antenna. So you just replace the small antenna with the big one here. And they claim that it works up to 100 meters. Well, the source code here has been compiled. So maybe we should try to see what it does. I have installed two payloads on it, and it's not blinking, so it's ready. I'll show you the first one. It's a payload that changes the background. So I will activate it now and try to watch my background here change. I press the button and down there you will see. Wait a second. I'll just put in this cable here instead because it's another payload. So is it blinking? Nope. Is it on? Yes. Let's see what it does. Can you see it's running some code down there? It's a PowerShell that is getting a picture from the internet and voila, new background. And payload 2 is actually, I'm uploading a test virus. It's also called an ICAR file. And let's see what it does here. Again, it's running script down there. And you should see down here. Yep, there you are. I've got a good antivirus solution stopping the ICAR file. Well, that's the purpose of an ICAR, is to test antiviruses. So that's it. It's pretty expensive. I think we will see a lot of similar projects to this. So you can get it cheaper, but this is definitely worth looking into if you're red teaming. And it's really good quality. I'm amazed about all the details and how quickly it works. So have fun. Bye. Oh, I forgot to tell you something really cool also. Because you've got all the source code for this device, you can go into the libraries and then you can find the file called USB, let's see here, include USB config.h. And if you edit that file, you can actually write your own serial. If you search for serial here, so you can write your own serial number. See, I typed in here, I don't know if you can see it on screen, but it says 1337. You can type in your own definition of the USB. So instead of it saying installing Ninja driver when you plug it in, it's here in my case saying USB charging cable. And you can put in here also a link to where the vendor name is. I just put in my company name there. So maybe I should show you. I've got a USB detector here, USB lock view. And when I plug in this cable here, nothing happens. But when I activate the cable, I'm not sure this remote was the one. Yeah, it was. When I activate it, you will see that it pops up with a line here, detecting the cable and running the script and so on. And here you can see the serial number. Where is it? It's empty, right? So if you recompile it and upload the source code with the altered serial number, you'll see 1337 here. And instead of presenting a Ninja device, you'll see a USB charger. So just an extra tip for you. And hey, don't forget to subscribe and like or dislike if you don't like it, or give me a comment below. Thanks.